Hi, my name is Martin, and welcome to my chess channel, Say Chess. And I'm started a guide for the book called Questions of Modern Chess Theory, a book by Isaac Lipnitsky, where several different strategic concept is explained. And in the current chapter, I'm working on the center. And in this game, I'm going to look at game between Michael Botvinnik and Ilya Khan, played in 1939. And here it goes: d4, knight f6, c4, e6, knight c3, bishop b4, knight f3, c5, a3, attacking the bishop, and bishop takes, and b takes c3. And now you can see that white has got double pawns, and I think this game really shows how to play with these double pawns and how to exploit the weak squares in your opponent's position. And let's see how Botvinnik managed to do this. And black replied queen to a5, attacking the c3 pawn, and white needs to defend by playing bishop to d2, and black went on to attack directly with knight e4, and white defended with queen to c2, and black took the bishop, and white recaptured with the knight. And black played a normal developing move with d6, and the same did Botvinnik, and it also opens up his bishop, light squared bishop. And here Ilya Khan decided to challenge the white center directly with the move e5, and you can see that he has not yet develop his knight and his white squared bishop, and he hasn't castled, and it can't maybe be a little bit premature. Another move would be to play knight d7, and the game could have continued bishop d3 and maybe h6 and castles. That would be have been a little bit more safe to play this way. But he played e5, and Botvinnik captured on e5, and black recaptured also on e5. And now you can see that there's white has double pawns in the c-file, and black has two undefended pawns on the c and e-file. White played bishop to d3, and black played h6, relieving the pressure on the h7 pawn and making it possible to to castle. White castled and black castled, and now Botvinnik went for f4 and asking this pawn, what do we want to do? And now black decided to develop his pieces and played knight to d7. Another option would have been to take on f4, and white could have taken back on f4, and I think this would have left black with some better chances, but it's still a hard game for black. But since he's behind in development, but yeah, the Stockfish evaluates this position around 0.0, but I think still white has the best chances of attack. But black plays knight to d7, and Botvinnik now moved past the e5 pawn, and it's getting closer to the black king. And now black played knight to f6. And Botvinnik played knight to e4, challenging this knight directly, and with the idea of playing his bishop into the center, occupying one of these two squares that are weak. So Ilya Khan played his queen back to defend the knight. He don't want to have double pawns near his king. So, but Vinik continued with his plan, and queen took on f6, and now Botvinnik continued, played bishop e4, and Khan now played the rook to b8, and this is as the idea of playing the b pawn ahead and making room for the bishop to enter the game on the b or a file. White continued with taking the open d file, b6, h3, and making it possible to play g4 maybe, and protecting the f5 pawn. Now bishop to a6, attacking the c4 pawn, and now Botvinnik continued by defending the c pawn. b5, attacking the c pawn again, and now White simply took on b5, and rook takes, and Botvinnik, he played c4, and the rook has to move back. Another option would have been to take with the bishop, and now White plays c4 again, and if black tries to exchange the good light squared bishop, then white can simply take, and queen takes, and now playing the rook into this excellent square, and you can see here that it's protected, and then it attacks these two pawns and can double with the rooks. So excellent position for white. But c4, rook to b6, and now Botvinnik challenging the rook. Ilya Khan developed his other rook to the d file, and Botvinnik took on b6. And now Ilya Khan got a very weak b6 pawn that Botvinnik challenged excellently. But he started by playing e4, creating this strong center that is hard for black to break down. Black replied bishop to c8, and now Botvinnik played the excellent move queen to a5, and it has several purposes. That the queen looks down on the e8 square if the rook moves up, and it can go to a7 or a8, and it can attack the b6 pawn, and also this pawn on e5 is potentially weak. So black defended by playing bishop to d7. But another move would have been queen to e7, and now white could have played f6, and rook takes, g takes f6. It's getting a little bit late. And now queen to c6, and now there's two attackers on this pawn. And if queen d6, now the rook can simply take, and if king to g7, now white takes the b6 pawn. Another move would have been rook to d7, and now Botvinnik could have played queen to a8, and best defense is queen d8, and now the queen simply moves over and attack this pawn, And if black tries to exchange queens, then Botvinnik can simply just allow it and play his rook to b1, and you can see that it's impossible for black to defend this pawn. So after bishop to d7, Botvinnik played queen to a7, and you can see now that I think this is shows perfectly that white has a completely dominant position, and this pawn is very weak, and you can see there's ideas of playing a6 and the rook over and attacking the pawn on b6. So and if you want to take a closer look, I will on the how this game ended, I will leave a link in the video description, and I will also leave a link for the book if you want to take a closer look at it, Questions of Modern Chess Theory. And if you want to follow me and know when the next video is up, please subscribe, and I will appreciate it very much. We'll see you next time. Bye.